Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I've been managing a task that was given to me. So I was building a website for a restaurant and they wanted to have some surveys for their staff and get feedback from their customers. Now, of course, you could do this with different forms that you have, but most of these forms don't give you things like reports. They don't give you things that are graphical in nature. So I landed on this wonderful tool, which is called SurveySparrow.com, and it does things a little bit better. So let's say I can have a form that I can drop in my chat, and basically they'll give you a blank form or a template that you can use. So let's say I use one for customer satisfaction. I can be able to just choose a template and create a survey for myself. Let's say these are the questions that I want to have. I can change the questions right here. I can add icons, add things like GIFs, or upload my own images from my own computer. Of course, this just basically allows your clients to feel at home, feel more relaxed as they do the survey, because one of the big reasons why surveys actually are not done is because they're boring, or they seem tedious, they seem like you're doing an exam. So this tool really did it well for me, so I'm just going to preview what I have here. And so when a customer goes to my site, this is the form they'll be seeing. And of course it's just something where they're going to click, find out, maybe this is the one thing that I enjoyed, and I can rate it using stars. Simple clicks, no need to have so many words, and this will allow me to have a wonderful report at the end of the day. You'll be able to see all your surveys, have reports, and see responses from different clients, and everything will be working. So the biggest plus for me using this tool was that I was able to put the form on my website, and then I could be able to do a number of things using the API they provide, and I could use them in my website. So in the settings here, you'll actually see that they have an apps and integration area, and you can use it with the different apps that are already built for you. So you could have some of those survey, you could have some of that data going to Google Sheets. If let's say your boss enjoys Google Sheets, you could be able to send contacts into Google, you could be able to do different things with the different campaign and marketing tools available, and you could even send this into HubSpot, which is basically a CRM if you want to use it that way. But you can also create your own custom app. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can do that and then use things like the webhooks so that you'll be able to do more custom things inside your own WordPress install. So we're going to create our own custom app, and I'm going to call it a TechiePress. And then I'll give it the same label, TechiePress app survey. And I'll say survey for restaurant app. And then I don't need to add a redirection URL. For now, I'll leave this blank. I'm going to leave it as active. I can add an app icon, but that's not something I want to do now. And the next thing that I'll need to do is I can choose the different items that I need to have here. So this app will allow me to manage webhooks. I can use it to manage questions because that's something I want to have. I can use it to view the survey. I can use it to view questions, manage the survey generally, view the webhooks. So for now, I'll just select everything, and then later we can always take off what we don't need. And after doing that, I'm going to create an access key. So I'll hit generate here. And then I'll copy this key because we'll need it a little bit later. So once I'm done with this, I'll hit save, and that will save my app for me. And when I scroll down here, you'll see that my app has been saved and it's right here. So when I click on it, you'll be able to see the client ID, the secret, the different labels that we added in, the choices that we made. We can be able to regenerate an access token in case we lost it, or maybe we think someone has hacked into our system. We can also be able to regenerate the secrets and actually get new ones, like you've seen right here. So this is basically for security. Maybe you have an IT policy that says every 3 weeks you should be able to change the different secrets that you have. So this will allow you to do this seamlessly with just a little click. Hit update settings, and then you'll have everything working as you want it to. So besides using the keys, you can also do some IP restriction as a bonus for your security. And you can also do other simple things like branding and adding your own colors, the company colors that you're developing. You can add your own logo, or you can remove it, or you can even say, I want to affiliate to this particular business so that you make a few extra dollars. And in the general settings, you can actually change the company name. You can add this to your own custom domain. Let's say you have your business and then you just want to access, let's say, surveys.myrestaurant.com. You can be able to put that as a subdomain in here, and then you'll hit update, and then you'll be able to access that via your own domain. Otherwise, let's go into the building of actual stuff here. So we're going to go back to the home panel, and it will open up the page that we have right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose this particular survey that we've made, and I'm going to choose to share the survey because that's what we want to do. We want to integrate it inside our own WordPress plugin. And we get a number of options here. So you can have either a link that takes you to the form. Maybe you want to paste this in an email, or you can use social media like Twitter and Facebook. You could send this as an SMS, you could create a URL that you prefer, or you can do these other integrations that have been made. Maybe you want to add this to a mobile phone and you have a mobile app specifically for, let's say, like this restaurant that I'm building for. They could have an app whereby they get feedback. So this mobile SDK would be something that's very helpful for them. And you'll find that having this syndicated together both on the website and the mobile app is actually beneficial. So you can have different places you're sending all of this, and this data will come back in this one place and you can always use it. So what I'm going to do right now is just basically embed this in my website. So I'm given this JavaScript code right here that will allow me have a widget on the front end, and I can basically resize it to make sure that everything is as neat as I want it to be. I can change the height and say, let's have this at 300, make it a little small. 400 is a bit better. Width shouldn't be 50%. I can change this to pixels and say, we'll make it a perfect square and have 400 by 400 pixels. That's good enough. And we'll say, let this be user invoked so that when this icon is clicked, we get the form. And we can change the icon we have either round, or we can have it with the border radius taken away at the end, or we can have something that's just a standard to say, hey, do you have a moment? You can say, leave us a review. And that's something that will make sense maybe to my locale. And you can choose an icon where you have a smiley. And this can be on the left or the right. And I'm going to probably choose the left. And then you can choose a different icon if that's something you want. I'll leave it with that speech bubble. And then you can change a number of settings here. Maybe you want to just have not all your customers respond to that and just say 30% of your web visitors. And that is because we might want to have a random sample space, but we are going to leave this at 100, maybe because we want to have all the possible amounts of responses from our visitors. And then once you're done setting this up and you have everything that you need, you can actually even set this to auto trigger so that people can always see that first question and then just keep on answering and giving you the options. You can leave it as user triggered or user invoked. So this is what I'm going to have, and I can use JavaScript. Now, since I'm working with WordPress, I can use JavaScript because this is code that can be imported and used inside my own website, or I can actually choose to say, let me have a WordPress shortcode. Now, this shortcode, of course, when you copy it and paste it inside your WordPress site, it will not work because this shortcode is not defined. So this has been made to give you an example of what you should actually do when you make your shortcode. but you need to define this JavaScript code inside the shortcode that you will develop. So this is what I'm going to do in the code. So after setting up, we'll hit save here. We are ready to actually share this with the rest of the world. So let's go into our website and then start developing what we need. So I'll just go back here, I'll click edit, I'll just keep this open so that I can reference it, but let's go and open up our editor and then we begin developing our site. I'll open up my editor and also my local server. I'll open up the admin section, and in the admin I'm going to open up a new page. I'm going to copy this WordPress shortcode right here. I'll paste it in here under survey. I'll open up the block editor and just use the shortcode block, and then I'll paste in my shortcode and then hit publish. I'll publish this, and now I can actually view my page, and you'll see that this shortcode does not show anything because it's not defined. So that's what we're going to do in our plugin by using this JavaScript. So I'll copy this JavaScript right here, and I'm going to go into my editor. I'll open up the files to my install. I'll drop my public folder inside my editor. And then I'll go to the WP content. Under plugins is where I'm going to open up a new folder that I'll call Sparrow Survey Shortcode. And again, I'll open up a file inside here, which I can call literally anything plugin, but I'll just call it Sparrow Survey Shortcode.php. And I'm going to just increase this so that we can be able to see what's going on. So inside my plugins, I have that folder and the file that I've created for our plugin. I'll start off with PHP because that's how we introduce plugins in WordPress. I'll use a code snippet that I've written in my editor that allows me to add all these different details in here. If you're using VS Code, you can actually find that extension that I've written and shared with you, and it's actually called Classic Press and Classic Press Snippets and Automations. And you can add it to your editor and then you'll use it and you'll be able to have this particular snippet inside it. So I'll go back and then inside here I'll change a few things. I'll change the plugin name to Sparrow Survey Shortcode, and then I'll change the link of course to the GitHub repo that I'll be having this. My plugin name will be that, and then I'll just copy this and paste it again, leave version that, and then add a GPL license, and then I'll just copy this at the end and use it as my text domain for my plugin. So under here I'll just do some little security stuff and say defined, and I'm going to look for, I'll use the apps path. If anyone tries to initialize this code in here without going through the WordPress system, then they, let's say they're a hacker, then we should just die at this point and say no entry or unauthorized access. So I'll save that, and then here just below we're going to start defining our shortcode. I'll use the add shortcode hook. And basically it's going to require us to have the name of the shortcode we want and the function that we're going to use to describe that shortcode. So here I'm going to add a shortcode, and I can call it anything, but for now I'm just going to use what we had been given and what we are using currently on our site. So right in here they are described that we use Survey Sparrow. Ideally, if we're going to make our own plugin, then we should use a different name, because Survey Sparrow might come up with their own plugin that does that, so we don't want to have a conflict of this. So right now, we'll leave it at that. If you want to take this to production, I would advise you to change it. We shall have our named function, which I'll call techypress underscore Survey Sparrow shortcode so that we can easily identify what we are working with, and then add a semicolon right there. I'll start my function, put the name, and then I'll write the code going in here. So what we want to do at this point is I'm going to escape PHP and open it up again to run it. And inside here is where I will paste the JavaScript code that we're going to get from Survey Sparrow. So I'll copy this, go back to my editor, and then I'm going to paste this code right here. There's nothing much I need to do, because this is all you need to throw at the front end and you'll be able to have it running. So I'll save this. I'm going to go back into my browser, and then I'll go to my admin section. I'll go to plugins. I'll activate my plugin right here, and then I'm going to go back to pages. And then I'll view my survey page right here. And when I view this page right here, you will see that we have this little drop down where I can actually get my customer satisfaction questionnaire coming. Answer that. I'll give a rate of 4. And then I'm going to say I am likely to do a 7 here. And then off top of the head, I would say food, drinks, and maybe merry making. I will then add an 8 here, likely to add that. I'll add no idea for this point. Click enter or click the icon here. I'll say love prompted me to give you an 8, and then I'll click submit. And once I'm done, this is going to go inside here, so I'm going to just go and review the results. And you'll see that in here they've already documented that I have one visited, and then an answer came in. So a number of people visited my site, saw this, and decided to fill in. So let me just reload this. I'll reload it 2 times, 3 times. I'll come back here and reload. You'll see that yes, my site was visited 3 times. So this is basically giving us a little bit of extra insight on our website. And our website has been visited 3 times. That button, particular button, has been seen 3 times. So this little tool that we are using just to do our surveys is actually giving us more metrics about our site. And it's letting me know that 3 times that particular page was visited, where that survey shortcode is, and then one form was started and one was completed. So you're able to know whether the form survey was started and then completed, and you can know your success rate in terms of completion. Now, with this, you can actually be able to make a report and you can find out what's happening. So you can try out this particular tool. Go to surveysparrow.com, sign up for an account, and then try to do this by yourself. I tried to answer the form the second time, but this time I did not complete it and stopped halfway. And that's why you can see here that we have the 8 questions are still there. We have 2 responses, and my completion rate is actually only 50%. So if I look at the results right here, you'll see that we have 6 times that page has been visited. 2 times was the form started, only once was it completed. And we have a completion rate of only 50%. And you can see the different questions that were answered. You are able to get the different answers in this report. So you can actually share this by downloading this PDF, scheduling a report, or actually copying the link and sharing it with someone else. Or you can translate this into Google Sheets to share with other people this data, or manipulate it in any way that you want. So some of the other tools that I want to actually try in this particular product are how they handle webhooks. So webhooks are basically like push notifications that you get on your phone. Let's say when you do a WhatsApp, you get a message. Because it's coming from someone else, it is automatically pushed to your number because you share a contact with them. Now, since this account of mine is sharing different items, let's say a mobile app, a website or three other websites, I want to be able to see how I can share information in real time from Sparrow Survey and then send it to my website. So that should be possible, and I am going to try it out in a video coming soon. So let me know in the comments how you've liked this tool. Let me know whether you're going to try it. Let me know how you'd want me to experiment with it. Let me know how you'd want me to experiment with it. And give it a thumbs up if you think this video was really nice, if it was really something that you would do in your everyday life. Otherwise, don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. Share the content with your friends and enjoy whatever you are developing.